Some toy cars have a wind-up mechanism inside. Pull it back and then release the car to watch it go. In this video, we're going to look at the gears, the spring, and that clicking noise you hear when winding up the car. That's coming up. If you want one of these toy cars to move forward, you can either push it, you could build a track and use gravity to move the car forward, or my personal favorite are the cars with a pullback mechanism. No batteries required, just firmly press down, pull back the car to wind it up, now release it and watch it go. Let's take a look at how this works. Take the case off the car and we're left with the chassis, four wheels, and a motor. The front wheels spin freely. There's nothing special about them. The motor is only connected to the back wheels. Now if you wind it up, you can see some of the gears moving. Let's open this up to see what's going on. There's five gears here, and right behind the biggest gear is a twisted piece of metal. It's called a torsion spring. The more you twist this, the tighter it gets and the more energy it stores. Once released, it will quickly unwind if allowed to do so. This spring fits quite snug inside the circular hole. If I pull it out, then the spring immediately expands, and it's not so easy to put back in, so be warned if you try this on your own toy car. On the large gear, there's some curved extensions sticking out the side. These fit right around the center of the spring. As the gear turns, the spring does too. When the car is pulled back, there's a chain reaction of gears turning. This is called a gear train, and it's what causes the spring to wind up. Let's take a step back for a moment and talk about gear ratios. I have two gears here of different sizes. If the big gear turns once, the small gear will turn around more than once. Now imagine the small gear had another larger gear attached to it. We could repeat this again with another smaller gear here. Turn the first gear just a little, and the last gear turns a lot. This concept is used in the mechanism for a pullback car. Now let's take a look at the car gears. There's one attached to the axle, and there's one right next to it. These always move together whether the car moves forward or backwards. We've seen the large gear. Now these two gears have a mind of their own. This one helps winding up the car, and this one helps unwind the spring and push the car forward. The wind-up gear can slide up and down to engage or disengage with the teeth on the large gear. On the side, there's a diagonal slot that makes this sliding possible. When we start pulling back the car, the wind-up gear engages with the large gear. When the car is released and starts moving forward, the gears move the other way, which disengages the wind-up gear so it's no longer in contact with the large gear. Now during this time, the wind-down gear is doing the exact opposite. The car is pulled back, the wind-down gear is disengaged from the large gear. You can see it doing a little dance while it tries to stay out of the way. When the car is released, the wind-down gear slides into place just as the wind-up gear slides out of place. The torsion spring is causing the large gear to spin, which then moves the gears, which then turns the wheels on the car. This is where the gear ratios come into place. The largest gear moves only a little, and the back wheels of the car turn a lot. This is part of why the car can travel so far on its own. When the spring has released all of its energy, the car keeps going on its own momentum. The large gear will stop, and the wind-down gear will disengage again. This time, both of these gears are out of place. This way, the car continues to move forward with minimal interference from the large gear. Imagine if the car abruptly stopped when this happened. It wouldn't be a very fun toy. Now, because of the gear ratios, you can move the car back and forth while firmly pressing down, and it still winds up the car. Watch the large gear here. Pull back the car, and the large gear winds up a lot. Push the car forward the same amount, and the large gear only unwinds a little. Back and forth, back and forth. Overall, the spring is still winding up. One last mystery is that clicking noise you hear when you pull back the car far enough. This is actually a clever failsafe to prevent you from overwinding the mechanism, which might damage the spring or the gears. On the outside of the spring, you'll see a little loop which fits into these slots around the outside. When the spring has enough tension, the loop will slip into the next slot. This is what causes the clicking noise. The sound means your car is just about wound up as far as it'll go. My name's Jared, and I'm a 3D animator here on YouTube. I like making videos about how things work. If you'd like to help me make more videos, click here to visit my Patreon page. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.